Good morning. That was actually my first sip of this tea. I know I might be American, but I drink tea like I'm British. I don't know why or how. Maybe it's because it's my coping mechanism or my go-to thing. I drink like usually like Tetley decaf tea with like a splash of canned milk, or I guess it's called evaporated milk. My grandma, who's also named Larissa, she taught me a splash of canned milk. It's so good in the tea. I love it. It's perfect. No sweeteners. That's disgusting. But since I don't do caffeine anymore, you know, I'm actually, sorry, I'm going to do my makeup while we talk. Since I can't do caffeine anymore, I used to be like a complete caffeine addict, and having that morning coffee, like, not only is it falsely, I mean, it does give you, you know, energy for a moment, but it's, well, I'm not going to start bashing coffee and caffeine just because I can't have it, so let's not even go there. It has its pros and its cons, let's just put it that way, right? But I think that one of the biggest draws and pulls to caffeine is the psychological mentality of, I'm tired, and this is going to make me feel better. And I've just recently learned that I don't have that. My cheap primer went squirting everywhere. I would say that I don't have that luxury of choosing coffee, but I still need that mental crutch of some sort to kind of push me along and encourage me. And I have a lot of ways that I do that, but specifically I wanted to talk with you this morning about nausea. Do you guys get nausea with your FND? I'm having so much shooting pain in my back right now, like in my rib cage. Oh, sorry. No, I'm not. Not sorry. Sorry, not sorry. Okay, let's see if I can actually be this tired, do my makeup, and talk to you guys at the same time. Okay, where was I? I need a crutch, can't have caffeine. I keep choosing sugar as some comforting crutch, and you know what? This stuff's poison for me, and I need to retrain my brain in, like, what is something that is actually profitable to my system that can be a crutch and not something that actually also takes away from it. And so I think that's where I'm trying to make changes. And one thing that I have a lot of is waking up and having severe nausea in the morning. And no, it's not necessarily what I ate or what I did, and no, I'm not pregnant, but I just have this crazy nausea where I will wake up because my stomach is doing like acrobatic flips without my permission. But it's hard to do what you need to do. You know, I'm a wife and I'm a mom, and I try to be involved in encouraging other people's lives and meeting with people and having coffee if I can, or having lunch, or just being a part of community wherever you can. And I think that the hard part is, it's just this new normal of adjustment to life. But I have no idea what I was even saying, you guys. I really don't, and that's frustrating. But the nausea is too much to handle in the morning. Oh, just being involved, that's right. Sorry. But I think it's the being involved and doing stuff in your life. And I'm a mom and I homeschool, we homeschool. She also goes to an art school, so that's nice. She volunteers during the week, and also has a social, multiple social gatherings that she attends as well. So, but she's an artist, and having that alternative school opportunity has been really handy for her to get to have a flexible life. And it kind of works because I have to have a flexible life too, don't you? Don't we all? We really need to. But I guess, so last night, I would say that pain, which... If you're alive and you're aging, you've got pain, and it doesn't matter if you have some chronic disability thing or if it's just normal wear and tear, but we've all got stuff in life that we have to kind of push through and survive, so to speak. And I just wanted to talk about coping mechanisms. For instance, in the mornings, I get up pretty early with my husband and kind of get the day going. I send him off with his lunch and breakfast, and that's something that I choose to do. It's a joy for me. It's my way of expressing my love by serving my family that way. And so it's part of my life, and there's times when things are really bad and I can't do that and we make adjustments, but laying in bed is not really an option for me because I have such severe stiffness and pain with my neck and my rib cage that, and my low back and right. But staying in bed is not really an option for me. So, I got to get up and I got to do these things. And like last night, I had to sleep on the couch again because of the rain dropping outside of my window is so intense that it just makes me thrash around in bed. So I had to go out on the couch and then I couldn't sleep and then I was in a lot of pain. And then I woke up this morning with just like less than 4 hours sleep and such terrible nausea. And it's like, I was standing in the kitchen and I kept going like staring off into space and then like, oh, what do I do? And one thing I will have to say that has been such a help for me has been music. So what I do is I get my favorite motivational music. Sometimes it's worship music. Sometimes it's rap artists that come from like a Christian background. So there's it's upbeat. I mean, it's not always upbeat. A lot of times they rap about hardship and the heart and how life is legit and hard. But there's a positive message to it, and it's not a bunch of negative language that I already battle with using on my own. So what you kind of expose yourself to, you kind of pick up. So I just try not to listen to a bunch of negative stuff or bad language, because then I'll just cuss more than I already do. So music. So this morning I was like, I'm just pretty much don't want to be awake for this, but I need to be. So I just put on my favorite album right now, whatever it is. I know that there's a lot of stuff that we cycle through that we love, but I look for something that's kind of motivational, and I put them on my headphones and I just pray and ask for help to get done what I need to do. And I just kind of try to push through it and do what needs to be done. But the music, it's so, you know what I'm talking about. You look up at like a gym playlist or something. Like, we don't go to the gym, us people. And if you do, please tell me your secret. No, I have a gym membership and I do want to start using whatever I can, but right now it's maybe yoga sometime, but I don't even know. Stretching, Tai Chi, swimming. What is that? I have a spot and I don't get spots, which really ticks me off, which means I really shouldn't have ate sugar yesterday. Okay. Music. What is it for you? What's your motivational thing? So mine's tea and music, and sometimes I will stay off of social media and say like, okay, I'm not going to do that. Or get on Twitter or Facebook or watch any vlogs or whatever until till I'm done with whatever I need to do. Or I will set up for myself like, oh, I'm gonna take a hot bath. No, I don't, but it sounds good, right? Like, that's something I should do. So I'll encourage you to do that. Like, oh, I'm gonna take a soak or go for a short walk or do some deep breathing. And kind of give myself, what am I doing? This is not my normal Mary Kay, and it's way more pigmented than I thought it was gonna be. I'm too tired for this. But that's the other thing. I'm doing it because it makes me feel better and I feel more put together, and it's all smoke and mirrors, you guys. Smoke and mirrors, and just kind of tricking your brain into overriding some of the propensity to fold. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's so easy to be like, I can't do this. I'm not doing anything. Forget it. I quit. And I don't want to live like that. I want to push myself. I want to get farther than I did yesterday. And sometimes you go back the day after and you're like, wow, yesterday I could do this same thing. Today I can't. Or last week I could do this without reaction. Today I can't. Like that whole Fort Vancouver thing. Yeah, that was ridiculous because literally on the way home, I all of a sudden got the most intense and severe headache and went home and could not keep my eyes open, had to take a bunch of medication, and could barely even stay awake. I just kind of dozed off and on while Darren and Madeline watched Dick Van Dyke. But it's a struggle, and it fluctuates and it changes, and I just want to encourage you to find tactics that can help you, because I'm sure that I'm not the only one that has this, that has children or responsibilities or a job, and you just don't have the luxury of not succeeding. And I feel like we can help our brains along by being creative and innovative and finding the things that you can to motivate you through your work. If it's like setting some kind of like I said, motivation, dangle a carrot in front of yourself, or by prayer or music or accountability or whatever, you know, it's going to be different for all of us. But I think that pretty much everybody in life can admit to having like the same struggle with pushing yourself. And I am definitely like the last person that should be talking about this, in the sense that, well, I'm not really great at routine. But I guess this doesn't have to be about routine. I mean, you can push yourself and be completely unregimented. Do you find that it's hard to keep a routine? I'm sweaty. I'm also sweaty all the time. It's so dysregulating, being dysregulated. And you guys forget, don't you? Well, those of you that have this don't forget. But those of us that have people, I forget, people that don't, I don't know what I'm trying to say. When we talk to people about our condition, I feel like I'll tell them this humongous list of things that I deal with. And then often when they ask, I try not to go constantly unloading it for no reason or where it's not wanted. But when I do talk about it afterwards, I always feel like, oh, well, there's like 20 other symptoms that I struggle with that I haven't even mentioned. So I am constantly having problems with sweating, or having the sensation of being cold, or being super sensitive to cold. Like the other day, I think it was yesterday, I had this small amount of ice cream and it was like a half a cup I'm getting confused here. It wasn't very much ice cream. Let's just say that. And it just triggered me to be really cold and started shaking and my neck seized up and it was really intense. And it's like, I can't even eat ice cream or pie without having some terrible reaction to like, and have a severe headache and, you know, hardship. It's just like, there's always something, right? I gotta confess, this morning I was so negative. I was doing my husband's lunch, and our dishwasher is currently broken, but thankfully our landlord is replacing it tomorrow, which we've lived here 7 years, and I am ecstatic about getting a new dishwasher. Maybe I can stop fully washing my dishes before I put them in there. But what the heck does it have to do with anything? Why am I talking about my dishwasher? I don't even know. And you guys, if you're even still watching, it's a miracle, because I don't even know what the heck I'm talking about anymore. Man. Well, it's just real life. I often forget what I'm saying. I mean, I'm not even, I don't know. It is what it is. And I am not editing these videos, so somebody professional could cut all this garbage out and make it look all perfect, but it's not real life for me. And I haven't learned how, I mean, I used to do that stuff, but it's been so long that I don't have the strength and the energy, but I want to share with you guys. I want to hear about your struggle. Like, surely, even if you don't have FND, surely, you know, you have things in your life that You have to push through, you know. Maybe you lost the use of one of your arms, or maybe you had a limb that you weren't born without, and you have struggles that, you know, you have to work through, or maybe you have a disease process that's ravaging your body, and or maybe you deal with depression and anxiety, or you're a caregiver for your dying parent, and you know, or you're or so. I mean, honestly, I feel like this is not, you know, a really small group of people we're talking about. We were all in the struggle and in the grind, you know. And I guess the whole message is, do things like, I'm doing my makeup and I'm already like, I am so much more awake. Look at that. A little illuminating and contouring and layer of layer to cover up the dark circles. Well, they're more like lines, but yeah, you know, I feel better. And if I wasn't talking incessantly, I would be listening to music or a sermon or news radio, or what is it for you? I love to read, but I've been too ADD for that lately. I also used to love to color. Oops. Oh, I'm not even going to curl my eyelashes. Not even doing that. I used to love to color all those really popular coloring books they have these days, but using my hand muscles like that actually makes my, I have so much weakness that I've had now since all of this. Like, I can't carry things. I can't open jars anymore. That are heavy, can't carry heavier things for long distances. I can't open jars as easily as I used to. And, I get, my eyes get fatigued blinking 20 times putting on my mascara, you know, or my jaw gets really tired just chewing food. But, don't worry, I'll keep chewing. I love food too much to cut back there. But I did cut back on the coloring, because what happens is it tightens up my hand, like starts to cramp and get really fatigued. And if I keep pushing through it, then my wrist gets kind of cramped up, and then my whole forearm gets cramped up, and then I'm gonna start shaking. And sometimes I can't even get, sometimes I have the coolest dance moves because of the whatever you call it. It's like amnesia, I swear. What was I saying? I'm like Dory! Oh! That's good. I'm gonna go with that. I'm like Dory. Or that dog in that one Disney movie, Up. The one that's like, squirrel. Right? But it's pain-induced. Like, when you're constantly being jammed and thrown about and stuttering or pain or overwhelming sensation of sweating, like, I can see the perspiration on my hands right now. Don't shake my hand if you meet me. It's probably sweaty. Maybe a fist bump is a little less sweaty. But there's just so many ways that it affects everything. And, yeah, you got to figure out ways to do what you need to do. Because, or, I mean, I've got a lady coming over today that I mentioned on my Facebook, like, hey, is there anyone that can come help me with food prep? Because I can buy my groceries, but I'm really having a hard time prepping food, and I'm a recovering food addict, and I've lost a ton of weight, and I used to be a total slave to food, and I fall off the wagon so easy, especially when I'm in a place right now where I need to have low maintenance. I end up like going to get Burgerville, which is a healthy fast food-ish, but it's not. And it's happening too much, or easy, quick things like sushi. And I just want to be more whole food minded, because I feel like I feel much better that way, but it's just hard work. But the point is, I posted on my Facebook that I needed help with food prep, and I just got on Facebook after being off of it for like 3 years. And this gal that just added me, who I barely know anymore, I can't even think of the names of her children. I think she has 3 boys, and I can't remember her husband's name. I honestly can't think of her last name off the top of my head. That's how little I know her, and I'm letting her in my life and in my house to help me with food prep because I need the help. So if my motivation to get done what I need to do is having somebody that I'm going to get to know, right? She's going to come over, we're going to get to know each other, and we're going to work together and kind of bond in her serving me in this way. And that's motivation for me. So like, I'm motivated to go into my fridge right now and bring out all the food and start thinking through those things because I know I have help coming. And you need to do what you need to do to get done what you need to get done. And you have to be willing. Again, I really want to not use that kind of verbiage. I don't want to tell you what you have to do. One would benefit from being willing to humble yourself, humble ourselves, to ask for help, and to be willing to acclimate to a new way of getting things done. You know, like, I used to be so self-sufficient, and I'm just not anymore. And I have to ask for help, and I'm excited because I get to know somebody new in a new way that I wouldn't have been able to before had I not reached out and said, can you come help me, you know? And I think that that's exciting and new and different, but it is what it is, right? So I just want to encourage you to think about, you know, what are the things that motivate you, that can help you? What are the things that you need to get done? Are you a mom? Do you still work? Do you have therapy that you have to push yourself through? Do you just have to endure and you need to be in your bed, but you can have more comfortable things like get a new pillow or a new comforter, duvet that's cozy, and get new lighting? Or somebody today on one of the Facebook groups said that they got a new coat and a candle. And those are the kinds of things that can help us feel better and motivate us. So this was longer than I wanted it to be, but I'm really long-winded, and that's why I hate Twitter, because I'm like, what? You're cutting me off? I haven't even said what I was supposed to say yet. So thanks for listening through all that. I really don't know if that was even profitable because I was so all over the place and forgetting, but I am dealing with multiple issues right now. I'm having some severe nerve pain shooting down my left calf, and it's really messing with me at the moment. But my makeup's done, so that's a good start. And now I can just go throw on clothes and start thinking about some meal prepping. How fun. What do you make for food that's easy and healthy? And or what do you have other people make for you if you're already awesome and getting help? So I hope you have a great day. I hope that you're inspired to help yourself out and find those around you that can help. And I look forward to talking to you again. Okay, have a great day. Bye.